So boys and girls, the Mona Lisa is so famous that millions of people come every year to go see it. It's always a little crazy when you go because you'll see here that it's behind bulletproof glass and there are a lot of people who cram into the museum to be able to see it. So people love it so much that they've actually made adaptations to it to just change it. Here's Mona driving. Here's Mona getting ready for the coronavirus. Here's Mona getting ready for a date. You might recognize this, a Lego Mona Lisa. Here's selfie Mona Lisa going, peace y'all, yo. Here's a little minion Mona Lisa. We've got an emoji Mona Lisa here. So fun to be able to take a famous piece of painting and change it. Well, our dear, sweet, talented Miss Adriana decided to make an 80s inspired Mona Lisa. And today we're going to be using her ideas and her inspiration to be able to begin making your 80s Mona Lisa as well. We're going to be learning a little bit about 80s style first. And then you are going to be starting to make your background for your 80s Mona Lisa today. So you can see here that she used many different backgrounds and many different styles. But first, 80s fashion. Here we are. When I was in high school, I would have worked weeks to buy a sweater like this. Look at these kids. That was cool. I'm not kidding. And back then, there were these cool glasses called shutter glasses. Totally a pain to look through, but oh, did they look cool. I remember this catalog. I remember wishing I could have that sweater. So let's look at some of the key elements to 80s. First of all, confetti. You'll notice in the background that there are little lines here and there. Here, Miss Adriana used a black marker to make confetti. Here, she used a white marker to make confetti. You're going to have both options available to you. And if you look here, this is something that probably would have been on someone's wall back in the 80s. You can see the confetti, and you can see that here they even made their confetti kind of jagged. The next thing you should know is that 80s style would have geometric shapes. These are the shapes that you learn about in math. The triangle, the square, the circle, the rectangle. And you can even make things like lightning bolts if you like. Another thing about the shapes is that the shape usually had a shadow. That's what made them so cool. So basically, in order to do this, you're always cutting out two of the shape so that you can glue down one, and then you glue down the second one just a little bit over from the first. If we look at this very cool guy and look at his very cool shirt, you're first going to notice what I told you before. There are geometric shapes. And up in the right-hand corner here, you're going to see some examples. The triangle, the quadrilateral, the rectangle, the pentagon, the lightning bolt. Not typical, but you can go with it. And then you're also going to see that there are shadows. If you look at the triangle in the lower left-hand corner on his very cool shirt, you'll see that there is a shadow shape. If you look at these designs back from the 80s, you'll see exactly what I've been talking about. Confetti in the background, geometric shapes, always with a shadow. And the shadow doesn't have to be black, but it can. Next are parallel lines. Parallel lines are lines that are right next to each other. That's why the word parallel has two lines that are next to each other to help you remember. So those lines that are next to each other, we can now look back and you can see, oh, they use parallel lines in the shapes here. Here they use parallel lines, lines that are right next to each other, cut out in the shape of a circle. Here you can see on this guy's shirt that he has parallel lines right there on the left on his shirt. So when we look at all these different styles, and we'll have these idea sheets on your paper, you're going to be putting all this together. Now, how are you going to do it? Let me show you. First of all, confetti. You're going to take one of my white markers very carefully, not pushing down on the tip, and you can draw your confetti. You can do it on any color you like, or again, you can use a black marker. I even had one boy do this with black and white on a colored sheet of paper. It looked very cool. So confetti is first. The next thing that you're going to be doing are your geometric shapes. Now you're going to notice that there are colored pieces of paper in your little supply bin. And let me show you a few tricks. First of all, let's say you want to cut out a triangle. Well, in order to have a shadow, you need two. So I'm taking that one triangle, I'm setting it on top of the yellow paper, and now I'm cutting out a second one. Just like that, I have two triangles. I can glue down one, and then I can glue down the second one just a little bit off so it looks like a shadow. Now, a trick you may want to try is to put two pieces of paper together. You hold it really hard with your thumb, and then you can go and cut off a triangle, and just like that, with one cut, you now have two triangles. Some kids even cut out squares this way out of their corners. They cut zigzags. Really fun. If you want a black shadow, then you would put a colored piece of paper together with a black piece of paper. You'd go ahead and cut it out. And now just like that, like magic, you have two shapes, a shadow and the main one. Now, in the back, there are circles that are already cut out. If you would like to take that circle, you have a pencil in your bin, you could go ahead and trace that circle and cut that out. Now, you guys have a lot of paper. If you want more, you can go to the back of the room and get more. But we really don't want you to waste your paper. So it's nice to get a lot of shapes out of the paper that you already have, or maybe share the rest of your paper with somebody else, and then to be able to cut out more and more shapes. Now you can already be imagining you're going to be gluing these down onto your background paper. And the only thing is that you may want to be mindful that when you glue things down, that you kind of figure out where Mona's going to go on your paper so that you don't end up gluing down shapes and then having to cover them up with your Monas. Now here, Miss Adriana is showing you how she's going to make some parallel lines in an easy way. What I'm going to do is slow it down here a minute so you can see. I took one piece of paper. Now I'm cutting straight up, but not all the way to the tippy top. I leave a little bit of space there. I'm trying to keep the lines parallel, which means that they're straight and right next to each other, just like that. Once you have all of them cut, and it doesn't matter how thick you do it, you then this are gonna lay it down, and you're going to look at each of those stripes, and you're gonna go every other one. So notice that I'm folding that up. I skip the next one, and then I fold that one up. Then I skip the next one, and I fold that one up. Don't go wonky. Try and have it be going straight up. And then at the very end, you're going to take all those elements, you're going to glue it to your background, and next week you'll get to make your Mona. I can't wait to see what these look like. Have fun.